Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We have a bunch of information to start today's video. First off, Inspiration4 posted a tweet of generosity, prosperity, leadership and hope. All smiles for our Inspiration4 crew during Dragon simulations at SpaceX's headquarters in Hawthorne, California. There was a tweet posted by Michael Sheets about the Crew 2 capsule Endeavour being moved soon. It says, NASA on July 21st will broadcast the SpaceX Crew 2 astronauts relocating Dragon Endeavour from one ISS dock to another to open up a port for Boeing's uncrewed Starliner capsule during the OFT2 mission, which is scheduled to launch July 30th. Somebody posted a speed test result from their Starlink internet with some very impressive speeds. Musk responded and said, "Glad it's working. The sheer amount of work done by SpaceX engineering, production and launch teams is amazing. Ping should improve dramatically in coming months. We are aiming for less than 20 milliseconds. Basically, you should be able to play competitive FPS games through Starlink." In response to that, Musk was asked, "Is ping being improved due to new satellites with better hardware or just more satellites on Earth orbit?" He responded with, "More ground stations and less foolish packet routing will make the biggest differences. Looking at the speed of light as approximately 300 km per millisecond and satellite altitude of approximately 550 km, average photon round trip time is only approximately 10 milliseconds, so a lot of silly things have to happen to drive ping past 20 milliseconds. Musk was then asked, "Does having laser links present in the newer satellites help in improving speeds and reducing the latency? Or they are mainly to provide internet connection in the polar regions?" He responded and said, "Laser links in orbit can reduce long distance latency by as much as 50% due to higher speeds of light in vacuum and shorter path than undersea fiber." In response, he was also asked, "What wavelength are you using for laser crosslinks, or is that top secret?" Musk responded with, "Similar to fiber optic. We are trying to ride the terrestrial fiber optic laser technology forcing function, but modified for use in vacuum." He then responded to his own tweet with, "If we can do this successfully, then anything developed for ground or undersea fiber is automatically better in orbit." There was another tweet asking, "No need for base stations eventually?" Musk responded with, "Some traffic could just go terminal satellite satellite terminal and never touch the regular internet." John Krause posted a super cool shot of the new drone ship, a short full of gravitas, as it arrived at Port Canaveral in Florida. Musk responded and said, "Version 3 of the SpaceX drone ship. Team did great work. Will be epic to see the deep sea oil rigs converted to ocean spaceports for Starship. Here's a view of the orbital launch site as it progresses." There is some interesting Boca Chica news posted in this CNBC article regarding the FAA and launch site. It says, the Federal Aviation Administration warned Elon Musk's SpaceX in a letter 2 months ago that the company's work on the launch tower for future Starship rocket launches is yet unapproved and will be included in the agency's ongoing environmental review of the facility in Boca Chica, Texas. Here's the cryotank shell construction at the propellant production site. Work continues on the 8th and final integration tower segment. This integration tower segment has since been rolled out to the launch site. This interesting unknown structure was spotted attached to a crane. Here's a view of the other mystery structure continuing to be worked on. There was a nose cone spotted moved to the scrapyard. Somebody asked Elon Musk, "Any Starship update to look forward to in the near future? Would love to hear more about Starship's rapid reusability with catching system, etc." He responded with, "Some of these design trades are still open but will be resolved soon." Starship Gazer posted a really cool shot of a flap spotted with heat shield tiles on it. I guess this will be for Ship 20, which is going to orbit. There was another new Raptor engine spotted delivered. Work continues below Super Heavy Booster 3. You can see the three Raptor engines. So, there was no static fire on Thursday last week, but here we can see the road and beach closures. As of now, there is a closure of tomorrow, Monday 19th, for the first Super Heavy static fire. Then they have backup closures posted for Tuesday and Wednesday. Everyday Astronaut also posted a tweet saying, "Get your bookmarks ready as we are keeping track of SpaceX's booster and its progress towards a static fire no earlier than next week. Read up on what happened so far and bookmark this article to stay updated." Musk responded and said, "Probably Monday. This super heavy booster 4 section was spotted. This super heavy booster 4 aft section was also spotted outside the high bay. The booster 4 common dome was seen being stacked inside the high bay. Here you can see more booster sections waiting to be stacked." As usual, to finish our Sunday video, here's the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, or Boca Chica Girl, who is out in Boca Chica all the time filming the amazing content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their great videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.